You may be wondering how to conduct a one-sample z-test in SPSS. And the answer is, not easily. You see, the z-test cannot be done directly in SPSS. What I mean is that you cannot do a z-test with the SPSS drop-down menus. Now, on the other hand, z-tests are math, and SPSS does math. So conducting a z-test in SPSS is not outside of our abilities. We just need to write some clever syntax. SPSS does not have a built-in option for conducting a z-test. There is one option under the crosstabs menu that examines proportions using a z-test, but that's not what we want here. Fortunately for us, if a test can be computed by hand, then we can compute it with syntax or code, and the z-test is no exception. But before we do that, we need to learn a little about syntax. Whenever you do an analysis in SPSS using the drop-down menus, what you are doing, even if you don't know it, is writing code. The effect of what you do in the dialog boxes is to write a code, called syntax, that the software uses to run an analysis. In every dialog box, you will find a button labeled Paste. Instead of clicking OK to run an analysis, you can click the Paste button to paste the syntax to a syntax window. There, in the syntax window, the syntax can be edited, copied, pasted, rewritten, and most importantly, run in order to conduct the analysis. Now, syntax is wonderfully beneficial. It can save time, energy, and make your research more easily replicated by you or by other researchers. So for instance, imagine that you and I are working on the same data set. You have conducted a complex analysis and you want me to run it. Instead of emailing me describing each of the menus and the options that you used, you could just paste the syntax and send it to me. I would open the data set, open the syntax file, and run it. Now, I have the output that is exactly the same as what you originally ran. If something is not working, I can edit your syntax and send it back to you. Of course, using syntax is not as simple as using the drop-down menus. So, let's practice using syntax with our social media analysis. First, want to give credit where it is due? This syntax was created by HowToStats. Great website. Well worth bookmarking if you are a statistics student. You can download this syntax from the HowToStats website. To use the syntax, you do not need raw data. Rather, you need to know the sample size, the mean of the sample, the mean of the population, and the standard deviation of the population. You will plug in those values to the syntax and then run it. So let's review the setup for this analysis. Researchers at the website Pingdom calculated the average age of users of social media websites and found that the average age of all social network users in the United States is a mean of 36.9 with a standard deviation of 10. This distribution is approximately normal. You obtain a sample of 25 users of the social networking site LinkedIn. The mean age for this sample is 44.2 years old. Is the average age of your sample of LinkedIn users different from the U.S. population of social network users? We're going to answer that research question, running a z-test in SPSS using syntax. So here is how you read and then use this syntax. Now, the syntax begins with a data list, in which the SPSS software is told what each of the data points will be. This names the statistics and parameters so that they can be used in analysis. We see that the data should be entered in the following order: N, which is sample size, sample mean, population mean, and population standard deviation. Next, we find these four numbers. Now, these come with the syntax, and these are the numbers that go into the data list. So, N equals 35, sample mean equals 105, population mean equals 100, and population standard deviation is 15. Now, these are the numbers that came with the original syntax. What you will do is change these numbers to what you need. You should change these values to the ones in our word problem about ages. Just double-click on each number to select it. So n equals 25. The sample mean, 44.2. Population mean, 36.9. And population standard deviation is 10. And that is all you do. Now, highlight the syntax and click the Run icon. Here in the output, we see that the Z statistic is 3.65. Yeah, that looks familiar from our analysis by hand. The p-value is p equals 0.00026. We would write that up as p less than 0.001. And Cohen's d effect size is 0.73. That's a large effect. I'm going to tell you a little bit about effect size in the lecture, What Does Statistical Significance Mean? And I will teach you about the Cohen's d effect size when we learn about t-tests. So in summary, the z-test was statistically significant, and the sample mean for LinkedIn users is statistically significantly higher than the population mean of all internet users. Once you have this syntax, you can enter any four numbers that you like and run that z-test over and over with new data. So have some fun with that. Once we have calculated the z-test in SPSS, we need to write it up in APA style, 6th edition. Now here's an example of how we might do this. I read through this example in the previous video, so I won't read through it again, but you can pause the video if you need to. Finally, why doesn't SPSS have an option for conducting a z-test? Well, the primary reason is that we don't use z-tests in the real world very often, so there's not much reason for them to code it into the software. And, of course, in a real-world example like the one we just did, we would actually use a t-test. So this missing z-test is really not too much of a loss. Regardless, our experience with syntax illustrates two important concepts. Number one, do not become a slave to the drop-down menus in SPSS. Yes, they make using SPSS easier. And they make it easier for instructors like me to teach new students about statistics software. But all those drop-down menus do is write code. The drop-down menus are not magic, and they cannot always do everything that you want done. Become comfortable, at least, with the idea that you are creating code, and that you can use syntax if you want to. And number two, regardless of what software you use, learning to code is always useful. Whether that is using the paste button in SPSS, creating formulas in Visual Basic in Microsoft Excel, or even learning to write code in R. Once you know how to write basic syntax, whenever you run into a challenge, you will have a way to solve it.